Welcome guys to part 2 of this tutorial. This one I am not doing live because I didn't get to finish the rest of this drawing within the live session. But anyways, this one isn't going to be a live stream, but I'll still be giving the instructions as if I would be. And I will post this tutorial that way. Okay. So I want to work on this orange section of the bottom end of the slug, and then we will move onto the slug in the background. So using Dahlia Purple PC1009, I'm going to work on this bottom section by paying close attention to my reference. Excuse me. Okay, now I'm going to use some of the indigo blue and go over the area I just worked on. Using the hot pink PC993. Then using the pomegranate PC195, put in the warmer tones. using Pumpkin Orange PC1032. Then Poppy Red, PC922. Yellowed Orange, PC1002. Coming back into the Poppy Red, PC922. I want to define those orange pieces a little bit more. using Process Red PC994. I'm going to add some of these pinkish purplish tones over here. Okay, and I'm going to blend that with my solvent. Using Canary Yellow, PC916, I'm going to enhance some of those yellow tones. Using Neon Pink, PC1038. using white PC938. Back to neon pink, PC1038, so I'm just working the details. Okay, now I'm going to work on the slug in the back. Using indigo blue, I'm going to define the bottom white and blue section, paying attention to my reference. Using powder blue, PC1087, I'm going to block in this color. And then True Blue PC903, gonna enhance some of the blues. then using Caribbean Sea PC1003. Now I'm going to blend. I'm going to use a bit of my white. I'm going to blend them. Okay, now I'm going to start working on the pinks on the slug in the back. I think I might start with the tentacle pieces using neon pink PC1038. Now I use pomegranate PC1095. the indigo blue, PC901, to fill in a dark area in the background. Mulberry PC995. Just going to work on the body of the slug. Using the hot pink PC993. I'm using lilac PC956. Magenta PC930. I'm gonna blend. Using indigo blue, I just want to fill this in. Okay, now I'm just going to slowly keep building up those layers. And I'm constantly paying attention to my reference photo, and if I'm unsure about a color to use, I compare my swatches. Mulberry, PC 995. using Black Cherry PC1078. Indigo Blue, PC901. Using Hot Pink, PC993. Using Lilac, PC956. Gonna blend. powder blue, PC1087. Gonna blend again. Using Raspberry, PC1030. Still using Raspberry, PC1030. using process red, PC994. Using Black Cherry, PC1078. I'm gonna blend that with solvent. Using hot pink, PC993. Now using the white PC938. Now I'm going to use the 0.7 Uniposco white paint marker to add the highlighted white bits. using the Grey Lavender PC1026. I'm just going to make some of those paint marks a little more subtle. Dahlia Purple PC1009. I'm going to add some purple in here. Indigo Blue PC901. using white. Okay, so I am going to call this piece done, so I am just going to find a nice little spot to sign it. So I'm going to sharpen my white pencil. And I think I will sign it right over here. Just a subtle little signature, not too overpowering and really, really tiny. And I think that looks really cute and nice, and I really love the colors. And that's it. So what we did in this piece is we used our Prismacolor pencils. We didn't end up using any of the Polychromos pencils because when we used our swatch to find the colors, we found all the colors that we needed right out of the Prismacolor set, so we didn't require the Polychromos pencils. So the Polychromos pencils actually didn't have as many colors as I would have liked. In this, the Prismacolor definitely had those, all those beautiful purpley pink tones that we wanted to use. But the first thing we did is we put our outline down. I freehanded this outline, but you could choose to trace it if you prefer to transfer it that way. And then we used two colors. We used a black pan pastel and a Pathello Blue Extra Dark Pan Pastel, and we filled in the background, and then once we blended in the background and then sprayed a layer of Mikador Fixative, we did that again for two or three layers, I think, and then afterwards we added some pencil in to just give more of those nice pencil tones that subtly sort of go into the background. And then we, while we were doing the background, we first covered the Sea Slugs in masking fluid. Actually, I have a little bit of a highlight I want to add here. So we put the covered the Sea Slugs in masking fluid to protect it while we did the background, and then we waited for that to dry, and once that dried we removed it. We worked a little bit more on the background before we started doing the slugs, and then we removed the masking fluid once it dried and started applying color to it. So we compared our color swatches to our reference photo first so that we could pick our color palette, and then during the process of doing each part of the slug we also compared the colors to make sure we were finding the right one. So whenever you're not sure about a color, take your swatch, compare it to your iPad or your printed reference, and then use that color at the time. And then we just gradually started layering in that way, and then as a finishing touch with highlights, we used our Uniposco white paint marker to add those extra little highlights, which just makes it pop a bit more. So, and then you can sort of scrape it off with the tip of your pencil if you want to make it a little more subtle, so it's not quite as extreme. And yeah, so the more you look at something, especially when you're doing finishing touches, you can really continue on for a while. So you decide when you are actually finished with the piece. But I really like the way it is looking, and it turned out to be quite a cute little picture. It's very colorful and pretty, and because it's something that isn't very detailed or anything, it is easy to just freehand it and go with the flow and just enjoy the colors, because this doesn't have to look like a seesaw. It's nice when you're doing a piece like this, you can just have fun with it. Okay, so that is the end of part two of this tutorial. I will be putting a time lapse on YouTube, but for those that want to see part one, that's already available on Patreon, and part two is obviously available now as well, because you can hear me talking about it. So I hope you enjoy these two tutorials, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!